Cranial nerve 8 is also known as the vestibulocochlear nerve. It carries information concerning balance and hearing. We're not going to go into all of the mechanisms of how balance is transduced or how vibration is transduced into something that we understand as hearing. We're simply going to talk about a little bit about the anatomy of the middle ear and the course of these two cranial nerves. So in the next section, the eighth cranial nerve is your vestibulocochlear nerve. This nerve is responsible for carrying the sensations of hearing and balance from your inner ear to your brain. In this slide, we can actually see the bony labyrinth of the cochlea, which is responsible for hearing. So cochlea is hearing. And we can see one of our semicircular canals, which is part of the vestibular apparatus, and that's the vestibular part. So vestibular is going to be balance. So vestibulocochlear, balance, and hearing. We're not going to go into the detailed anatomy of the signal transduction of these two sets of apparatus within the inner ear, but we will talk about the path of the cranial nerve that goes from these structures into the brain. So the cochlear portion, again, we have our cochlea here. Sound waves are turned into an electrical signal that your brain can understand as hearing. And this happens via hair cells that live in the cochlea who are connected to neurons in the spiral ganglia. So the spiral ganglia is for the cochlea what the DRG are for your peripheral nerves. They're where the primary sensory cell bodies are located. The spiral ganglia then projects to the brainstem, which of course is in turn going to project to the thalamus. And that's going to be to a specific thalamic nucleus called the medial geniculate. And again, we'll talk about the medial geniculate nucleus when we talk a lot more about the thalamus. Finally, from the thalamus, that information goes to the temporal lobe. And remember that your temporal lobe right here is the primary area for hearing. And so that is quite literally where you hear. Information comes in through the cochlea, through the spiral ganglia, brainstem, thalamus, but you don't really hear until that information gets up to your temporal cortex. In the next slide, we'll talk about balance. So as I mentioned earlier, the vestibular apparatus is what's going to be the signal transducers for your sense of balance. And this is rotational or acceleration, so how fast you're going, and if you change direction. So getting dizzy on a merry-go-round is definitely activating your vestibular system. And also your relationship to gravity. You always know which way is up. And so that is another function of your vestibular system. And you can see part of it here with your semicircular canals. So semicircular canals are mostly with rotation and speed. And the utricle and saccular are gravity. Again, you have to have sensory neurons. You have to have those primary sensory neurons that are going to relay the information from these structures and turn it into a signal that the brain can understand. Those neurons live in the vestibular ganglia. So the vestibular ganglion is similar to the spiral, except that it's getting information from the utricle, saccule, and semicircular canals. Again, we go right through the brainstem. We go from the brainstem to the thalamus, and then we go from the thalamus to the parietal lobe. Because remember, the parietal lobe is your primary somatosensory cortex. And so you want that, your body sense of where it is and how fast it's going, hooked up closely to the rest of your body sensations. So whereas hearing is going to go to temporal cortex, where you are in space and how fast you're going and what angle you're going, what angle your motion is, are going to go to your parietal lobe, so it hooks up with your primary somatosensory cortex. So what do I want you to know about these particular cranial nerves? So I want you to know which cranial nerves carry special sensory information. So know what your special senses are, know what cranial nerves carry them. Also, you need to know which modality is associated with each cranial nerve. And then what areas of the cortex do they project to? So knowing where the optic nerve eventually ends up, we're knowing where information from the vestibulocochlear nerve ends up. I want you to know all of that. And if you do, once you know those things, you're ready for the assessment.